I said, you're
here, bitch.
I'm back with another reaction video. They tried to stop my shine, but they could never stop my shine. This is the T-Will Show. Okay. Do you hear me, baby?
I hear you, baby.
Ronnie Lewis Productions. Now, y'all know about this channel. Y'all know how I get down. Don't play that bullshit-ass music video shit. We've seen Ronnie Lewis, but I ain't seen enough of Ronnie Lewis. Five types of music videos out there, and we're gonna see which type this is. Now, he either gonna do the narrative type of music video, he gonna do the performance type of music video, he gonna do the narrative and performance where it's telling the story, but then in the middle of the story, the rapper starts rapping to the camera, but the story continues to go on within the music video so your attention could stay locked in. Or he gonna do the experimental performance where I don't think he gonna do that because, you know, that requires cartoons and, you know, illustrations and people that's very creative. Not saying Ronnie Lewis ain't creative or nothing, but nigga, it seemed to me you just hold a camera to the star. All I'm saying is, with every great artist comes a great director. Let's go.
I might move out to London or something.
All right, so with this first shot right here, we noticed that this is gonna be a performance music video. Cause he's rapping to the camera and there's no storyline going on back here. It's just two women and him rapping. So by me seeing this, I'ma expect this is gonna be a performance party type of music video. He gonna perform to the camera, then there's gonna be certain scenes of maybe them jumping off the yacht, maybe them jet skiing, maybe them swimming. And this is what I don't like. When you bullshit me. I just know there's so many other things you can do with this music video called This Summer. You could have actually did a whole party on the beach. Had a whole bunch of people, you know, them beach balls. Had some people playing, you know, beach volleyball in the sand. Some people throwing footballs. I think, wasn't this around spring break time too? Y'all could have got some, you know, some kids from spring break in the music video, gave it a real authentic party type of vibe. And then put the little performance in there. But no, all we get is two.
I might change my own number or something. Gotta watch how I'm coming this summer. I might double or nothing this summer. Getting rich with my brother this summer. When I smoke, I get dumber and dumber.
Now this right here, in the music industry, in film industry, we like to call this catering to lyrics. He said, when I smoke, I get dumber and dumber. Then you caught a clip of him smoking. Now, usually, this is what amateurs do. Now, a real creative genius would have thought, you know, okay, he says when I smoke, I get dumber and dumber. So let me take those exact words and create a simile or metaphor in my head to maybe what he could be thinking of. So instead of me recording him smoking, when he says when I smoke, I get dumber and dumber, let's record a video of you laying down, acting crazy. Not even acting crazy, just laying down like you off that shit. But then as you laying down, it zooms out and shows that you laying on this yacht in the middle of the whole ocean. Yeah. Yeah. When I smoke, I get dumber and dumber. And it just shows, nah, that's not the case. When he smokes, he feels like he's on an island by himself. That's what he's saying. You can't just listen to the straight up lyrics. You have to dig beneath the lyrics and find out what they're really saying. When he smokes, he feels alone. That's when you put him on the yacht in the middle of the ocean and zoom the camera out to show he's alone. And then quick scene transition, have some smoke hit the camera, and now we're back into the music video.
Might go to Miami or something, just to kick it and get on the yacht.
Now he says just to kick it and get on the yacht, and that's when you decide to use my scene of him on the yacht. And you zoom out to show that he's by himself.
Hate it.
Now, I would give you credit for this one if you didn't already cater to the lyrics and the, you know, two lines before where he says, when I smoke, I get dumber and dumber. If you're gonna cater to the lyrics, I'm just saying, don't cater to every fucking lyric. Just find you a strong one you want to cater to. You want to do the yacht, then do the yacht. You want to do the smoke, then do the smoke. What's next? You gonna show Miami? Daryl, you need to switch up your surroundings. Mm-hmm. He's still just comfortable. Just for a little bit, you need to switch up your surroundings. You need to maybe go to Atlanta, Houston. You need to tap in with some people who actually want to film.
You should go to Vegas, if anything. Go to Vegas or something.
You need to tap in with some people that's hungry, that don't just want to film you because it would help them grow, but people who actually want to film a music video because they want to, you know, get their point across. They want to show they got it.
And the music, too.
Yeah.
Because you can't look me in the eye and say this song do not sound like a lot of other shit that he's put out within the past couple months. Like, all the shit sounds the exact same. Mm-hmm. It's not different. And he always sounds tired.
But I don't know if that's, you know, the demographic you're trying to get into, or like the type of niche you want to be in, as like, oh, I want to be the laid back rapper.
To be at the top, they don't actually listen to music, they just waiting to see if it flop. They just focus on nothing but numbers, and they can't even see it's a bop. I'm comparing my numbers to Drake, so I can't even see it's a lot. I'm in Beverly smoking a blunt, trying to get high as a bitch with the gang and they toting a gun.
See, this is what I'm saying, bro. I'm sorry, bro. I just don't like the nigga that records your music videos. Ronnie Lewis, bro. You're not here with me, man. I got my shirt off for a reason. I'm ready to get down. Ronnie Lewis, you just cater to lyrics too much. And it's like Ronnie Lewis has this thing with him where he feels women attract views.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know if Ronnie Lewis grew up watching you. Because in 2016 through 2019, that's what you did. You were in LA, and of course you had the LA skeezers coming in and out of videos, and that kind of blew you up as well, because it was, people like to see, you know, you interact with women. Now,
we love women.
Everyone loves women. It's just a thing that pussy makes the world go round. You know who has pussy? No, I'm not going to go there. But Ronnie Lewis seems to have this, you know, this thing about him where he feels women, some ass shaking, and catering to lyrics is all he has to do to make a music video. Now, Ronnie Lewis, I don't know you personally, but to me, it's giving lazy, nigga. It's giving, every time DDG call, you say, okay, you put your few things together, then you go back to sleep, then you wake up the next morning, you say, let's go shoot this music video. It probably take you about, 5 hours out the day.
You don't even do a concept board.
Like,
we don't have concept.
DDG, does Ronnie Lewis send you treatments for his videos? Like, just a whole PowerPoint of what he wants the video to look like so you can read it over and say, yeah, I like this, I like this. Because all great, you know, directors send over treatments to their artists of, I heard this song, this is what I envisioned in my head. I'm going to send this over to you, whole PowerPoint showing you what it is, and then you're going to, oh, you only record DDG, because we're on your website right now.
Oh, he's done video for
me. You've done Gunna, Wiz Khalifa, YoungBoy. Okay, it seems like you do enough rappers to where you understand. You don't have to do a lot of shit. No, this is Sosa Man featuring YoungBoy. You didn't even get a YoungBoy music video. You got a nigga that got YoungBoy on a song. He's a YoungBoy when he was like 17. How old is this? 4 years ago. Man, Ronnie Lewis, you done pissed me off.
Why you watching that bitch shake her ass? Go ahead, get behind the bitch. Lamborghini is too fucking fast. She ain't been in.
Lamborghini is too fucking fast, and of course you showed a fucking Lamborghini.
I hate to say it.
I'm breaking it down.
Cause no, I'm gonna say what it is. This is the nigga y'all go to when y'all not trying to spend a lot of money. That's what I'm getting. And as a person who feels, also you do treatments. Your treatments is this bullshit. You do treatments and then give them that bullshit. That's crazy.
Oh my god. DDG, I'm breaking it down. What I said earlier is facts. You need to get up out of LA.
Yes.
These niggas are not creative down there. I know they might, you know, they might give off the image that they're creative because it's Hollywood. But no, that's where the studios are. The creatives come from outside of Hollywood.
A wise woman in a New Orleans mall told me that this specific mall was the second stop when it came to fashion. It went to New York. Then it went to New Orleans. Then it went to Dallas. Then it went to LA. And furthermore. That is how I think of artistry. You over there with them LA niggas. You over there with them LA niggas. I mean, Andre told y'all niggas years ago, the South has something to say. And for some reason, y'all thought we stopped talking? Y'all thought we stopped? We don't ever stop talking down here in the South. We don't ever stop talking.
And ever since Andre said the South got something to say, the South been speaking.
And we have always spoke, and we have never stopped talking. And for some reason, you want to be up there with them city niggas like they doing it for you. What is being done? And DDG, I'm sorry to say, but it ain't good. But out of all the ones you have put out, the best one has been the one with Halle. But even that one low-key pissed me off because it's like, why are y'all in the pool? So exactly what are you in LA doing? When it comes to the producers, when it comes to the directors, what is happening?
In the wise words of Mr. Jordan Peele, get out.
She gobbled it up, fucked around and I bought her a book. Told my mama that I'ma be turned. Get her out of the hood and it worked. Was banking on God and hope. I'm not human, I know I'm an alien. Or whatever that thing was on note. Was a joke. Niggas started this shit was a game. So much shit that I don't entertain. They be trolling that shit really lame. Stop, do not call me cause I'm on a mission. Bitch, I'm waiting to be at the top.
I don't even hate to say it. I will say it. I feel the real artists are the ones that actually give a fuck about their music videos. Because I'm thinking back to Amana Leo when she tweeted, do y'all really care? For her to even have to ask that question, I think it's her having to ask herself, like, am I doing all this work for nothing? Because she's probably seeing shit like, who are the people you've done? A Boosie, a Young Boy, all these other people that are generating all these millions of videos. Not because of the video in itself, because of the song, or whatever the case may be, or because of the artist in itself. And y'all won't be honest with these artists no more. Y'all in yourselves as consumers lack wanting substance. Y'all lack wanting creativity. Y'all don't even care about shit no more.
And that is why we are here.
That's why we exist.
We are... The balance.
And I'll say shout out DaBaby. Because it seems like DaBaby is one of the other few people within this generation's rap that actually cares about his music videos too. And we even gonna talk, like, throw it back to that video he just did with Gucci Mane and 21 Savage. And DaBaby got a whole storyline over here. He pretending to be a plug in 06. That is what he's pretending to do. He pretending to be a plug in 06. What y'all niggas doing? Standing outside like it's 2023?
And
well, no, niggas staying outside in 06, but I'm just saying, like,
and just to let y'all know, I was in the premiere comments saying DDG X DaBaby, and niggas was laughing at me. They were saying, oh, DaBaby fell off. What are you living in, 2020? Well, nigga, it is the 2020s. We're still in them, and DaBaby done fell off and came back on, and he still has great music videos. And y'all think that I'm tripping saying DDG need to get with DaBaby? It's for music video purposes. He gonna open his mind, expand his brain to different things. DDG,
you're a YouTuber. You have this creative ability. You make literal storylines with your family. I saw you in the, we saw the Nine Lives video. He has that creative thing. What story am I seeing that you're on a fucking yacht? What is this telling me? He is a streamer, he is a YouTuber, and he is also a rapper. Like, I feel like if you're talking about what he's going to do this summer, more than likely, he's going to propel in these avenues. Show me what I'm finna pop off this summer doing this. I'm finna pop off this summer doing this on you niggas. I'm finna pop off on you on this summer doing this on you niggas too.
Ronnie Lewis, you really pissed us off. This is a 30-minute video.
And you do this for all your artists. So really, we on DDG. Oh, you know, no. I'm sorry. We are on Ronnie ass more, but DDG, because we know you have the creative ability, I'm kind of on you as well, because it's just like...